So, well, gypsy moths have destroyed thousands of trees in Mount Gretna, but this summer is proving to be a different story.
News 8's Lebanon County reporter Barbara Barr joins us now, and she shows us why the gypsy moth caterpillar invasion appears to be over, at least for now.
We're hoping the population has collapsed.
Gypsy moth caterpillars, the scourge of Mount Gretna and other woodland areas in Lebanon County, are on the way out, thanks to a combination of aggressive spraying and nature's own devices.
The moisture that we've had with the amount of rain is allowing the trees to survive very well. It's also bringing on a fungus that has been killed a lot of the larvae before they've gone into the pupa stage, so they're not able to lay the eggs.
The proof that the three-year rampage is over is in the trees.
You can see the canopy is completely green. There's no holes in the leaves.
And on the deck of the ice cream shop.
Last year, the tables were literally black. The droppings, like right this minute, would be coming out of the trees that you really couldn't be under here.
Chuck Allwine was able to clean up that mess, but the gypsy moths and their voracious appetites did irreparable harm to the forest.
We had brown mountainsides due to the defoliation.
This is a stark reminder of the damage the gypsy moths caused in Mount Gretna. Acres of trees had to be cut down, too diseased to be saved. Timbering and clear cutting took place last winter.
The game lands in Governor Dick. Everybody knows what happened up there. I mean, we just lost thousands of trees. This year, basically zero.
While some scars remain, the outbreak appears to be over, and foresters don't believe the county will have to spray next year.
And we believe we'll be in the clear for the next 3 to 5 years.
In Mount Gretna, Barbara Barr, News 8.
And the county sprayed 3,300 acres at $20 an acre this past year.